and fail due to fatigue. Because it's constantly rotating, the same point is undergoing compression. Now, it turns out that you can just use this equation to size the shock. Okay, there's a lot of calibrations. The diameter of your shaft is already calculated with this equation. That NS is your safety factor. N is your bending moment. K is a factor. We talked about that. One, go through this. This is your endurance limit. Basically, if we talk about steels, steels will have endurance limit. Basically, your stress. This one is spread out from the ground. T is your torque, sigma y is your force. Basically, this equation tells you that the material may fail to fatigue, this is for fatigue, and that is for compression. Because there is the torque, there is the torque. In order to do this, you need to assume first of that. Okay, you need to, because some of these factors require and then you use this calculation, or use this equation to calculate your D. If your D is about the same as your assumed diameter, then so you first have to assume the diameter. This is the diameter. So for your case, because you're looking for a small gearbox, I think you can start off with that. And you see if this diameter is actually smaller than your okay, if you start with 5, after you do a calculation, you end up with 6 or 7. This is the minimum diameter. So if the minimum diameter that you're coming within this equation is bigger than you assume, so NS is your safety factor. You're familiar with safety factor. You can use about 0.5, 0.5 for reliable materials. Sigma E is your endurance limit. Generally, we use to read this off from the strength cycle diagram of steels. You can include the assumption that the endurance stress is about 0.5. That means something, okay? That means that you need to go to now, last year I didn't really impose on this, but I think this year, last year, manufacturer, you should have materials. The material is, they will tell you the material what it is, what they want to use. Because this is important that what you use in your calculation is basically what you have. Last year was a easy course. So for your case, I want you to provide the material data so that you know exactly that if you use a UTS of 1000 MPa, that is the material that you get. Ask your workshops, okay? They get the material from somewhere. to start all over?
If you want.
Okay, as I said, most likely you're going to use skills. Okay, it's I doubt you're going to use any other types of skills. The only question is what type of skills you have learned. So you should ask for a stronger skill, not necessarily a mild skill. Mild skill would be the most common one, but you should ask for a stronger skill, a medium class skill, at least. But whether or not your workshop can give you that is another thing. Like I said, medium carbon steel can be heat treated, but most likely they will supply you which is in a condition that is not heat treated. Because once it's heat treated, you basically it's very difficult to machine it. Okay, so like I said, for other materials, you can use a fatigue strength cycles diagram, but it's unlikely that you have to use like a nickel based alloy or something. Because your cost, your budget isn't allowed for that. Like I said, at least, or should I leave that to you? It depends on the availability from your workshop. From what we can see, medium carbon steel, which we will look at. Okay, but medium carbon steel also, they have different numbers. We talk about that in a different lecture. But you should also right now identify which workshop you want to use. You should be asking them what kind of materials you can get. Okay. This K is a factor. It consists of a multiplication of many, many factors. And we go through this. So first one is dependent on the condition of your shaft, how is surface finished. If it's ground, then you use this number, and I think most likely your shaft will be ground. So most likely I think you'll be using this. Unless you use a diameter that is cold drawn, that means there's a finished diameter is exactly the same as your shaft, then you may use this number. But I think the likelihood is that you machine your shaft and you'll be using this round surface finish. So it also means that you should specify to your workshop that you need it to be ground as well. The second factor is a size factor. Like for your case, it's going to be less than 50 mm, so you're going to use this equation. The size factor basically tries to take into account that the bigger the component, higher the chances of crack. But for your case, it should be straightforward. This KC is a reliability factor. Basically, it talks about how the shaft is manufactured. Whether out of 100 shafts that are manufactured, how many percent will not be very good. Basically, a very conservative number will be 50% of a shaft is not good, but that is quite unlikely, that's not a very realistic statistic. So a reasonable number is that out of 100 shafts, or out of 10 shafts, one will be not so good. So 90% reliability is a reasonable number. So likelihood is that you choose that number. For your case, the temperature factor, you fall in this range, so your KD is 1. So this is the fourth factor. Outside of these temperatures, which are likely for you to be using. For your case, your shafts are also used in a quite simple loading, so you just pick PE equals 1. This is for reverse bending, so you don't have any shock, for example, you don't have any check in your shafts. You have a KG, which is miscellaneous factors. With any unusual loadings in this highly corrosive environment, but in your case, it's again simple, so let's just use 1. Okay, so we have A, B, C, D, so we are left with 1, which is F. I think the F1 is something that F1 is to be look into a bit. So the F, we talk about notch sensitivity. Okay, if you look at your shaft, especially if you have a step shaft, you can see you have quite a lot of discontinuity. And F, we talk about this again also later. This KF basically talks about how this discontinuity will affect the integrity of the shaft. So basically, this is a stress concentration factor, because every sharp corner, every sharp edge, you will concentrate the stress. So this KF is to talk about the concentration of the stress and how it affects the shaft. And it's given by this equation, Q is your notch sensitivity, KT is your geometric stress concentration factor. Okay, again, the procedure is not difficult. You first must determine the geometry of a component, so you may have a step change. Then you look at your material, what material you have, and you determine the Q of a charge. Okay, and then you do the calculation. So let's look at this. So you talk about steel. The steel will have different UTS, so that's why you need to know the material. You need to know the material search, because you need to know the material property of the steel. If it's 800, you just go to this chart. What is your radius of the notch? Okay, what is the radius that you're looking at? The corner. And then you read out from this chart. So if it's a radius of 2, the steel of 400 MPa is about 165. So you just read out from this chart. Different materials will have different notch sensitivity, so you have to refer back to the sensitivity. Since your vision is looking at steels, just refer to this chart. The stress concentration factors also you read out from the chart. So for example, you have a step change in your diameter. Okay, it will look like this. You have a bigger diameter, you have a smaller diameter. And you also have a radius. You read out from this chart, what is the ratio between these two? Okay, you're given here different ratios. You're given here the ratio of your radius. So you know your radius, you know your diameter. Okay. Then refer to this chart. This is the line for different diameter ratio. This is the line for radius over diameter. You can read off your KT from here. And this is for a step change in your diameter. This is for a notch. Proof. Again, read off from the chart, given R, small d and big T. You can read off KT. This is if you drill a hole through your shaft. Again, you're given a small d. And this is a tube. And A is your okay, do you want to do an exercise? Okay, let's say you select your shaft material steel with 1000 MPa, reduce stress at 770 MPa, and you use a safety factor of 2. The radius of the fillet at the gear shoulders is 3 mm. The shaft nominal reliability is 90%. And assume that the shaft has a stepped shoulder, which will locate the gear. So how do you find yourself? Okay, so actually if you have a shaft, okay, at every diameter you need to do this calculation. You have a step shaft. So the first thing you have to do is find your moment. Okay, this one, this question will be at the top. So you go to the top. You go back at the equation, okay? E is equal to. You have a shaft, how do you find the moment? Calculate the force and then perpendicular distance and then I give you a clue just now when I threw this one. Sorry, I got clue. So what did we do here just now? First, free body diagram, okay? It's going to look like this. Okay, you only have one gear. You know where the gear, the contact point, then we'll have a force. Radial force and a transverse force. Remember last week we talked about that. Because in this case, you need the weight of the gears. you can see here the force at the gear. You have two forces. They are in perpendicular directions, so you will have two directions for your reaction. At your support, you will have two reaction forces in perpendicular directions. In this case, we call this a vertical, this is a horizontal.
Is lonely.